What is up, YouTube? Today we're doing a popsicle stick bowl. So went out, picked up this little gallon jug, got some giant popsicle sticks that have been sitting in the garage for about 6 months now, and have finally decided to do something about it. So picked these up at a local craft store, probably Hobby Lobby or Walmart. I can't even remember. It has been so long. So here I am, basically trying to show you these popsicle sticks and having a really hard time actually getting them out of the package. But there they are. They're that big. We're going to take them out of the package and essentially take that tannin that we had used over for some scrap, take some, what is that? That's not super glue. What is that called? It's called glue. I don't know. Craft glue. That's not what it's called. I can't remember. I'm having a brain fart. I've been doing a little bit of drinking because it's football Sunday. So anyway, so we got all the popsicle sticks glued up here. We're just putting that on the tannin. Basically just getting the shape that we want for this particular project. So instead of going wide, we're going for height on this particular build. So here we are, got some waste blocks in the middle of that, trying to save that epoxy as much as I possibly can. And I had this other group of popsicle sticks left over from another project that I just now got around to. And basically just throwing that in there, it's gonna be like a hodgepodge of like larger and smaller popsicle sticks up to this point. I did a different popsicle stick bowl months back, and that didn't go so well. So instead of just laying them on top of each other, we're just gonna angle them here, sitting upright. So that weird looking stuff on the top where it's got the block for the tape, I was trying to make something to where like the popsicle sticks wouldn't float in the resin, because if you float enough resin into a pot, anything that's wood will float. So basically that was just there trying to keep everything just down so the resin could settle. And I ended up not having enough initial resin for this particular project, so I had to come back and hit it with a second cup of resin. And I wasn't trying to go to the tippy top of the gallon jug, but I was just trying to just cover the top of the popsicle stick. So put it in the pressure pot, got it taken out, and the casting went really well with it. Took the tape off of it, and it just slid right out. Boop, there it is. Have some bubbles in it, which I wasn't too excited about, but the overall casting was good. There weren't any visible cracks that I could see in it, so I was pretty excited about that. Managed to take that top part off of it, just took a spindle gouge, hit it on the top, or a just a regular, I think I took a screwdriver and just basically popped that thing off. And then I just took it over to the sander, and my finger is still injured from that initial injury a few videos back. And now we're just basically working down all those popsicle stick material, trying to get everything nice and flat so we can put the face plate on. And this part went really well. Those popsicle sticks obviously melt against the sandpaper, so not a lot of issues there. So here we are after the sanding. There's the face plate. And took my new Ryobi drill and attempted to initially put that into the resin, and we had some problems right off the bat and couldn't get them in there. So had to come out and get my compact driver or impact driver. DeWalt versus Ryobi. Obviously you already know who the winner is, but you know, we're all on a budget, so it happens. So took my impact driver and wasn't able to get that one down. I had to actually take a screwdriver, not a screwdriver, had to take a pair of pliers and actually get that out because it broke off. So got that onto the lathe, here we are, and then boom, immediately started dancing because this is a pretty large oblong blank. Taking everything off, you can see the spindle over there, that handle just dancing all over the actual project. And I tried to like narrow that down, but it keeps vibrating apart. If there's enough vibration, it's just not gonna do what you initially want it to do. But the tailstock obviously was just there to secure everything. So once we got everything kind of into that cylinder shape that we typically like, then we just went back and started making the mortise, which kind of had me a little bit worried because I was just concerned that we weren't gonna have enough material in the back to really get the chuck seated enough where it wouldn't fly off the lathe. And spoiler alert, surprisingly, no flying off the lathe on this project, which is surprising because if you watch this channel for any period of time, you know how infamous I am for all of my projects flying off the lathe. So here we go, got it reversed on the chuck, and now we're just taking the gouge and basically just roughing everything down to the part that we want it. You'll see here in a little bit, or a little bit later in the project, I tried putting the chisel on top of the bowl, trying to see how smooth everything was. And as cylinder or cylindrical as everything looks, it really wasn't that even. So I had to hit it quite a few times to get everything nice and even, especially toward the bottom there, because I was getting a lot of vibration still on the lathe, and that was just from everything not being even. So then I went back with the round carbide tool and just basically trying to make everything nice, even, and flush, so we can get to the gouging part of it. And I was I wasn't too worried because there was enough wood product on top of epoxy that even if, you know, I messed up, it wasn't going to completely take away from it because the wood was there to kind of just negate me from, you know, chipping too much of it off. So here we are, got everything nice and smooth down, and now we're starting the gouging process, which this admittingly took forever to do. I need to get another deeper gouge because once we started getting deeper, I would say I'd say a third of the way down, we started to have some real issues with the ability to get down there and really even everything out. Here we are a little bit later in the project. This is the round carbide tool that we're just using to gouge everything out up into this point. And I'm getting a little bit of chatter toward the bottom end of the bowl, but not too bad to where I'm like stabbing at it. And then I had to take three different size chisels or three different size gouging chisels to actually get down to the depth that we initially wanted. But once we did that, I mean, this took about an hour to get done, just making those small shallow strokes. And then again, hitting it with the round carbide tool, trying to get those walls evened out nice and even, which by this time in the project, everything else is going pretty relatively well with it. And then I gotta stop saying on these videos too much. I'm surprised nobody comments with that, but here we are getting everything rounded down nice and neat, and everything's going real nice and smooth. So once we got to the depth, then we just hit it with a 340 sander coming back and then hitting it back with the micro mesh. And there's my giant finger that's still kind of messed up from the project, but hey, sometimes you get injured and you gotta sacrifice that pain, for the woodworking gods. So here we are just taking that wood wax, polishing things up really nice and neat. And it looked a lot better on the lathe than it does at the final reveal, but overall I'm really happy with how the project initially turned out. It was just frustrating trying to gouge that deep without, you know, a deeper gouge. And I'm grateful that it at least didn't fly off the lathe. So here we are, here's our final project. It looks a little sloppy, but I would say, you know, the small little bubbles we couldn't get out, at least I didn't have any crackage on the wall. So hope you like the project, and don't forget to subscribe. I'm going to go watch football, and I'll see you guys in the next project. Peace. Okay, so project is done. Problems. Well, I'm still injured. Obviously, you'll be watching this later down the road, but yes, yeah, still injured. So, problems, yeah. It didn't fly off the lathe, though, so that's always good. Here you go. Here is the little bowl slash little pot with no top. So I've done some Popsicle 6 bowls before in the past, but this one turned out really well. We were able to gouge it a pretty decent amount. You can put a decent amount of stuff in it. But overall, the project went really well. Just had a lot of trouble gouging out something that deep. Plus, I'm hunched over and my back is all messed up from having to do that. But overall, the project went relatively well. We didn't have any big issues. Just some gouging issues, but I'm learning to use the round carbide tool to kind of get everything, you know, out of the bowl because it's not so wide, so it's harder to get in there. But overall, really happy the way this turned out. This looks super duper neat. This will probably go to one of my nurses or schedulers at work, but overall, really fun. So, hope you guys like the project. Don't forget to subscribe. My finger, I sacrifice. So, anyway, I'll see you guys in the next project. All right, bye.